I think for me the most underreported story is American political or geopolitical intent. Not actions, but intent. I would like to know why. I would like to know what the goal is. I would like it spelled out for me.
Hermetically sealed.
I think that is an inaccessible concept. But that is the most underreported story, and very few, except in the alternative media, where it's mostly about opinion anyway, are willing to go and take a look under those rocks.
I'm going to pick on one that I have sort of an obsession with, and I've had an obsession with for 2 years, so even though this is an underreported story today, I'm going to say that I think it has long-term consequences, which is the impact of the avian impact of H5N1, the avian flu virus. I became obsessed with it in 1997 when Harper published an article about the capacity of the flu virus itself to find a successful host in the humans, and in having mutated to that point, become incredibly deadly along the lines of the 1918 epidemic. I think in my incredibly cynical perspective, I think one of the problems that the world has today, and I think it's part of what we've been talking about, is overpopulation and incredibly intense competition for a limited number of resources. One of the things, the consequences I see of a pandemic, a global pandemic, that is incredibly powerful and deadly, is a rebalancing of the human presence on Earth, basically. And I think that the realities and anxieties about what would happen if that pandemic were to actually occur have not been explored at all. As far as we saw a grade school friend of mine on the West Coast, and his girlfriend worked within one of the city planning structures in California. And I said, of course I took this out, oh my God, do you do like avian flu planning? And she said, oh yeah. And I said, so if 50% of the population stops showing up for work because they're afraid they're going to get this flu, that means like our electrical grid starts to shut down, it means our hospital workers stop showing up, it means that basically the institutions that provide the basic structure, civil society, that we depend on a daily basis, food, transportation, refrigeration, power, clean water, those things start to break down, and they break down really quickly. And Steve and I have spent our professional careers in environments where those civil services have ceased to exist. And I don't think Americans have a clue what that means as far as consequences. And if you have simultaneously, you have a significant population, percentage of the population dying, you then have, frankly, corpses. You have a major health concern as far as not being able to move the dead and bury the dead quickly enough to keep up with it. And frankly, nobody's going to want to.
That's the big issue, you see. On day one, people just stop turning up for work.
Right. And so I just think that the exploring, and it's a small spark that's required to move this flu from where it exists today as a problem for birds into a problem for humans. And if that happens, the global human consequences of that for America, but obviously for the rest of the world, are profound. And in some ways, in the long run, if you overlook the deaths of a billion people, maybe even positive in some way for humanity's future. So
I'll tell you what's an interesting comparison, though, I don't know whether this is a human nature thing or whether it's peculiar to the people who were involved at the time, but the Chernobyl nuclear disaster. There were people who essentially gave their lives in order to cap that reactor.
Yeah.
And they did it very quickly. They did it knowing that it was going to kill them. Those guys who were flying helicopters over the top of the reactor while it was still burning, and they all died very quickly and very nastily. And they knew while they were doing it that was what was going to happen to them, and yet they still got out there and did it.
And I think there is a population of people in any society, I think, that will do that. Mm-hmm. And that we were just in a class discussing martyrs, and who volunteers for martyrdom and why. And I think that You watch movies like Braveheart. You watch movies like The Patriot. You watch movies like what's the one about the starship where he goes into the
Independence Day.
Right, and you see people who are giving their lives for what they perceive as the greater good, as the greater community good, and I think even in a situation like a pandemic, there will be those people, whether they are the stopgap, whether they are the people that make the difference and are able to change the course of it. Only time will tell.
Yep.